Now we are going to discuss about flyweight design pattern theory principles and real life examples. In the next video, we will try to cover the flyweight design pattern practical implementation using Java. So first, the definition for flyweight design pattern is it is used to create a large number of objects of almost similar nature. For example, if suppose if you are going to if you need some thousand copies of some data, the data is in our system. So what we would do is there are two options. So first option is we will try to get the printouts for 1,000 times. So we will get the expected output, which means 1,000 copies of actual data. The other way is we can get printout of one copy and then we can use that copy for taking the Xerox copies of other remaining 999 copies. So by doing the second way, we can save some amount of money. For example, if the shopkeeper is trying to demand 1 or 2 rupees for a print, for a copy for printout, then 1,000 into 2 rupees, then the total amount that we need to pay to the shop owner is 2,000 rupees. If we take one printout and then if we ask the shopkeeper to do the Xerox copies of the for remaining quantity, which means 9999, then we could save nearly 1,500 rupees. So in software angle, in software applications also, we can reuse something. If we can reuse something, then we can save memory. So by saving memory, it eventually improves the performance. So flyweight design pattern is one of those which saves some amount of memory by reusing the existing objects. So it is used to create large number of objects of almost similar nature. If the objects are in similar nature, then we can create n number of objects without expanding the memory, without bombarding the memory. We can reuse the objects. The second definition is large number of objects consumes large amount of memory. The second point is, so this is known, large number of objects requires large memory. If one object requires 1 MB, if we require 1,000 objects of the similar kind, then 1,000 into 1, we need 1,000 MB memory. Flyweight design pattern provides a solution for reducing the load on memory by sharing objects. The main principle behind flyweight design pattern is share the object which can be shared. It is used to reduce the number of objects created and improve performance. So if you reduce the number of objects that are getting created, then we can eventually improve the performance. That is directly proportional. Reduce the number of objects, then improve the performance. So if you want the better performance, then you need to reduce the number of objects. And the third and the fourth point is, sorry, fifth point is, it reuses the already existing similar kind of objects and create new object when no object is found. So we can relate this point with the real life examples using Angry Birds so that you could get the information in a better manner. So for example, we would have played Angry Bird game many times. So for example, we consider this one of the Angry Bird. This is the base Angry Bird, which has 2 eyes, 1 nose, and 2 legs. These are the features of this Angry Bird. If we need thousands of similar objects, then we can reuse this object. If we require a similar kind of object, for example, we need this object but of red color, then what we can do is we can use this object from the cache and then we can apply the red color on the fly. So this is the power of flyweight design pattern. So we can create n number of objects of this similar kind without expanding the memory at the runtime. So here we are reusing the object, but we are applying the additional features on the fly. So that's the point. It reuses the already existing similar kind of objects and create new object when no object is found. If a new Angry Bird of different dimensions is required at the runtime, for example, if a new Angry Bird with 2 eyes, 1 nose, and 1 leg, 2 eyes, 1 nose, and 2 1 leg, This is the requirement at the runtime. We don't have any objects of this kind. So what this pattern suggests, try to create a new object if it doesn't exist at the cache. So what it will do is it will try to check whether this object is already present or not. If it's present, it will try to reuse that object. If it doesn't present, it will try to create the new object at the runtime, and it will try to reuse for the next successive request. So this is the response. It reuses the already existing similar kind of objects and create new object when no object matches form. And then intrinsic states are constants and stored on memory, and then extrinsic states are not constants and needs to be calculated, and that are not stored in, they are not stored in memory. So here intrinsic states are those things which can be saved in memory. For example, this is the one angry bird object and this is another angry bird object. Here two eyes, one nose, two legs are the constants that can be saved in memory. Here two eyes, one nose, one leg are constants that can be stored in memory. At the runtime, if we need two eyes, one nose, two legs, angry bird with red color, here red color is extrinsic states. If we need two eyes, one nose, two legs, angry bird with the blue color, here blue color is extrinsic state that can't be stored in memory, because that I had at the runtime that would be used for that request only. So that need not be stored in memory. These are the some points about the flyweight design pattern. We will try to write a Java program for this in the upcoming video. So please stay tuned to this video. If you want to learn software design patterns in a detailed manner, then you can download the book. The book link would be present at the description box of this video.